This video is about the connection of a load cell. We will see that how the load cell wires are connected and where we give the supply and what is the output. As we know, in a load cell, the strain gauges are connected in a bridge which is called a Wheatstone bridge. Like this, the strain gauges are connected. So we give the supply to the load cell and when we put the load on the load cell, it gives us output. Here, one point of the Wheatstone, we will give the supply positive volt, and on this point we will give the negative supply. This is also called excitation volt or the supply. So the positive and negative supply is given on the points of the Wheatstone bridge. This supply may be 12 volts, 24 volts, 5 volt or 10 volt. It depends on the controller which we are using to measure the weight. So the controller supply is given at the points of Wheatstone bridge, and here we will get the output signal, which is in the form of millivolt. So here is the output of the load cell in the millivolt form, positive and the negative. So these are the connections. The colors of the wire is red and blue for the supply or the excitation, and for the output color is green and gray for the positive and the negative millivolt at the output. Here another Wheatstone bridge, we will see what is the connection of a 6 wire load cell. Here we will give the positive and the negative supply as for same as we give on the 4 wire load cell. This is the excitation volt, this is a load cell, and at the output we will get the millivolt. So there are two extra wires which are called the reference wires. These are the reference wires, also positive and the negative. These are used to measure that the volt we are giving to the load cell are reaching correctly. Suppose we are giving 10 volts and at the load cell these are reaching 9 volt because of the cable resistance or some problem, then our result will not okay, it will give us error. So with the reference we can measure that our voltage, how much voltage are reaching at the load cell. These are for the more accuracy. As on the load cell we can see, if we are giving 5 volt supply and our load cell maximum capacity is 50 kg and its specification or the output are 2 millivolt per volt. So at the 50 kg it will give us 2 multiplied by 5, which is a supply, it will give us 10 millivolt on the load of 50 kg. If we put the 25 kg, it will give us 5 millivolt. So by this way we simply calculate the output. I will show you the cable colors. For the supply positive, the color is red. For the negative excitation volt or the supply volt, the color of the wire is white. For the output signal, which is the positive signal, the color is black for the positive, and for the negative, the color of the wire is green. For the positive it is black and for the negative it is green. So these are the colors. For the different manufacturer, the color of the wires are different. For the reference wire of the load cell, the blue is the positive reference and pink is for the reference negative wire. So these are the colors. Now we will see that, as I told you, different manufacturer gave the colors differently. We will see the three manufacturer: Sartorius, the Schenck, and the Diacel. For the Sartorius, the supply positive wire color is red, and the negative supply wire color is blue. So red and blue are for the supply, and for the output signal, the positive wire color is green and the negative output wire color is gray. Red and blue for the supply and green and gray for the output of the Sartorius load cell. For the Schenck, the supply, which is the positive excitation volt or the positive supply which we are giving to the load cell, the wire color of the positive is black and the negative supply wire color is blue for the Schenck. So we will have to remember, for the different manufacturer the color may be different. We will have to consult the manual for the proper color coding. For the signal, red is the positive and the white is negative for the Schenck. Reference, if we are using the 6 wire load cell, the reference positive is green and the reference negative is gray or pink. So this is for the Schenck, and I told you for the Schenck we use the supply or the excitation AC volt, while the other manufacturers design load cell for the DC volt. The Diacel load cell, which is manufacturer of load cell, the color is for the positive supply, the color of the wire is red, and for the negative supply of the excitation volt of the load cell, white. Red and white for the excitation volt, red is for the positive and white is for the negative. And for the signal, black and green, black is for the positive and green is for the negative. I hope you understand the connection of a load cell, 4 wire and load, also the